And today, of course, we will be introduce the circuit factor. Last week, we just say the Bessel rule. And today, we said another measure for the uncertainty knowledge. Uncertainty knowledge. That is famous in the circuit factor theory and evident reason. And another part, we will into the fuzzy and fuzzy reason. That is quickly introduced about the fuzzy theory. Fuzzy theory and the application of the fuzzy. Fuzzy for the like Mandani reason and Suganon reason. That is very common. And until now, many manufacturers or many engineers use the method to design some product. And here, we introduce about the circuit factor. And next class, we will have a test on 10:20 or 10:20. 10:30 or 10:30 in the morning. So that is just a simple rigid test. The test is an open book. You can select some information from our material. Okay, what is a circuit breaker? Circuit breaker means the human give some value to the some evidence, not like to the Bessel reasoning. Bessel reasoning sometimes based on the test is because that is probability problem that can do. But circuit factor, circuit factor is to for the value we assign in advance. Usually have a paper say that very old that for Meissen. Meissen used the idea of circuit factor to do the reasoning. Plus one is definitely true. And minus one is first. So they define some term, define some term about the circuit factor. This is the term definitely not. If the term is maybe not, its value will minus 0.4, and maybe will plus. Plus 0.4, this value is defined in advance. That means in the future, if you find some term, that described in linguistics, then we can make it to a certain better value. Then we can do the computation. So, the rule based on circuit factor became like this. If evidence is true, then hypothesis. That means if this has this evidence, then this hypothesis circuit factor has given a value. For example, this is maybe. If he arrived early, he may be. Can do something. Then the maybe is mapping to a value. Mapping to a value. This is the circuit factor. So circuit factor reference believe in hypothesis H, even the evidence E is occurred. And then we can find this. This is he designed a formula in the paper machine. This formula, how we get this formula, that sometimes based on not based on statics or some theory, not just a combination. Combination, and you think that it is legal. This is legal. So here, pH means the higher probability of hypothesis H being true. PHE is probability hypothesis H given true based on the evidence E. So we get the maximum value. We can find if the maximum value is pH, then pH minus pH, this term will be become zero. Means that if pH and this term is maximum 1 and 0 minus pH. So this term just a combination, have no big meaning. But here, MB means that the belief, belief. And MP means that disbelief, disbelief. So that is inverse. If the value is high, this value will be low. We define this term. So we use certain factor by a formula, MB minus MD. So this is just for you to reference. Now we can define some formula by ourselves. That is based on the logic. Based on this logic is legal or illegal. So from the belief and disbelief value, we define the circuit factor. So that means we find the circuit factor. We need to find the MB, MD first, based on this method. And then we calculate the circuit factor value. For example, here is a simple example. If A is X, then B is Y. And then we have a real rule. This is only one term, but here has two circuit factor value. That if S is S, then B may be belong to Y. The circuit factor is higher, 0.7. But B also may be belong to Z. At this time, circuit factor is 0.2. Sometimes the circuit factor, who define the circuit factor? Sometimes by Esper also is okay. So that suppose it has been observed that in some case, if part of the rule is satisfied, an object A taking on value S, object B can be applied some different value Z. So that's based on the circuit factor. And the circuit factor, another type of research we can apply to rule. For example, if the sky is clear, the forecast is sunny, the circuit factor is 0.8. And current circuit factor, sky is clean is here, circuit factor is 0.5. Then the full of this circuit factor, that means from hypothesis to evidence. So the circuit factor includes two parts. The first part is evidence, and second part is the result. So we find this rule circuit factor fully, that is 0.5 multiplied 0.8. So we say that is 0.4. The result can interpret it is intimately sunny. Why making to intimately sunny? Because the value is 0.4. 0.4 making to the table. Making to the table is this term, 0.4, maybe. So he used linguistic to make it. The forecasting is sunny, it may be sunny, because these are these two fully operation, these two fully operation. So we also can combination of many different conditions. So we say the disjunction or conjunction. That disjunction means the or. Conjunctive means the end operation. So for example, in this rule, circuit breaker H, that he has multiple evidence, E1 to EN, that is a conjunction operation. Conjunction, so we find the minimum value. Why conjunction use minimum? That is based on the best logic operation. For fuzzy reasoning theory, they define. If you do the conjunction operation, then it's certain minimum. Certain minimum means that the worst case is a hot condition. So they select the minimum. For example, here have an example. We have two evidence. Sky is clear. Forecasting is sunny. The Asian is wearing sunglasses, have a certain factor. And they also give us the sky is clear. Maybe where we can get this information, maybe from the climate information on website you get and something. Because the climate reporter also said tomorrow sky is clear, the percentage is 80% or 70%. Now you can match it to the certificate value. And the certificate value of vocation shiny is 0.7. Then so have these two value. That based on the conjunction rule operation, we select the minimum. And then multiply this one, multiply this one. So the minimum is 0.7, multiply 0.8, and we get the 0.56. That is based on the conjunction. Why multiply? That is based on this rule. But just only is 10 here to be conjunction or disjunction. How about the disjunction? Disjunction means the or operation. This symbol is also like the or operation. And in mathematics, that is union. And above is intersection. Not the same meaning, but here we use the disjunctive. Disjunctive means we select the maximum. Disjunctive means that any condition satisfied, that is satisfied. So we use this one. So we select the maximum value 0.6 and 0.8, for example, here. And then we select maximum and find this rule. The circuit factor is 0.72. You also, after find the rule value, you also can make in the value to a linguistic table to find the mating linguistic. For example, if the 0.72, then our previous linguistic table, we can find this linguistic table. We can find that may be more close this one. Maybe you can define more time to make in the certificate rating. Almost certainly, more belong to it. So that is the meaning of the conjunction dual operation. And then, if we have another condition, it's based on the not just only one dual, maybe two duals, but how we operation of the two duals on certain factor reasoning. So when the same consequence is obtained as a result of the execution of two or more rules, the individual certifier of this rule must be merged to given a combination certifier for hypothesis. Here have two rules. For example, if S is A is X, and then C is Z, the certifier 0.8. Another rule is B is Y, then C is G, certifier 0.6. What certifier should be assigned to C? If these two rules, all of them are fine, both are fine, but how we could reason in the result of C is belong to G? So this is another, we need to have a formula, how to combine multiple rules. So there is a method that try to combine these two rules. This is a formula. If we find the CF1 means the rule of the one is rule number. So that means the rule 1 certifier. CF2 means the rule 2 certifier. So here means have two rules are fine. Two rules are fine. But if you say if I have multiple rules are fine, for example, 3 rules, 4 rules, how we could do it? This is like the machine learning, support vector machine. Support vector machine classify data into two class. But if you have a multi-class 1-2 separation classification, then how we could do? We just separate two and then separate two recursive. This all the same. You try to find the rule 1 and rule 2 to find a value. Then this value became maybe the CFM. This M can be with 3 combinations and so on. But this formula, we can find. If we write a mathematical formula, we can find. We can find if CF1 is 0, if this value is 0, then the value is CF1 at CF2. And if CF2 is 0, then the this term will be 0, and the result is CF1. So we can draw a curve along CF1 and safe two. Safe one and safe two. So that based on the relation, relation. But how we get the formula? The formula just try to be legal for the logical reasoning. For example, if here we can find if CF1 is zero, CF1 is zero here. And then the output value is CF1 at CF2. Output value is CF1 at CF2. And we can another condition is this condition is when CF1, CF2 value is positive. But if he is negative, negative we can find if he negative we can CF1 is minus and CF2 is minus and CF1 is minus, this term will be plus, this term will be minus. So it became minus at the minus term. So the result is minus. So that is legal. Legal means the circuit breaker is minus. Then the result is minus in both of them. This term means that circuit breaker is positive. Then the result is positive two. But this term sometimes is positive, sometimes is negative, depend on the value of CF1 and CF2. For example, so here he use the term is all. Or here the all is not the general all, because all is only one condition satisfied. But here we hope to find at this one. At this one. If this one is positive or negative. So that means both of the symbol is different. If the symbol is the same and positive, we use this formula. The symbol is the same with negative, we use this formula. The symbol is one is positive, one is negative, we use this formula. Now from this formula, as we know, certain factor value is not greater than 1. Not greater than 1. So this is select the minima. Select the minima. Select the minima. And then the certificate 1 and 2 cannot be 1. Both of them cannot be 1. Because we select minima. So and here is added together. Added together is the symbol is based on which value? Abstract. Abstracted value is bigger. So the symbol depend on that. So this formula is important for the certificate try to find their value. Try to find their value. So certificate provide a price test to present reasoning. The heuristic combination is different, would be combined if there were probability. So the idea of certifiers sometimes is good for some cases. I think the certifier idea a little like the heuristic. As we know, many methods we combine user experiments into the system. We define some heuristic rule. Because we cannot use the mathematical model to do well in this condition, sometimes you can use the heuristic to guide the result. The certain factor is, this idea is the similar, because the certain factor value sometimes is from the external or from the expert experiments to define. So when we comparison Bayesian reasoning and certain factor, that probability is the oldest and the best established technical to deal with inexact knowledge, and random data. The software in such area for testing, planning, statistic data is usually unavailable, and the current probability statement can be made. So, Bayesian reasoning sometimes based on you have more probability that can do. Now, sometimes based on your data, you can get the data, many data, so you can do it. However, in many areas, the possible application of the expert system rely on static information is not available. We cannot assume the conditional independence of evidence. As a result, many research have found Bayesian method unsuitable for their work. This is satisfaction marked by the development of certifier theory. So, although the certifier approach that the mathematical correctness of the probability theory, its outcome subject Bayesian reasoning in such area is diagnostic. So this, even the Bayesian reasoning had a mathematical model inside, but sometimes the result is not good for the user, for the system. So in this condition, now maybe certifier will be doing well than it. So certifier that sometimes he also can combine with some statistic data. But he also can combine with the expert or expert knowledge. For example, you can define multiple rules. One rule is come from Bayesian reasoning result. Some rule is come from expert. From Bayesian result, you can give them a certifier. Expert, you can give them a certifier. Then based on the certifier of multiple rule, can combination. So you can combination them, then together, also can be used in your research. So the certifier approach also provide better explanation of the control flow during the rule systems. So So the certificate, sometimes you also can think maybe like the weight, like the weight. So the best method is likely the most approach if reliable test data existed. The knowledge engineer able to lead and the experience available for serious decision analysis conversations. So in the absence of any of specified condition, best approach might be to apply and even best to produce meaningful results. So this is why we need to compare both of them. Then we have some homework, and the homework we have put it on the website of homework. I merge them, and because I set time, maybe after retesting, you can find from the Chuang class. On Chuang class, you can find it. Now we give an example of the reasoning of multiple rule. For example, I think we just from this example to this time here. Here is the work. If A is S, then C is Y. He has a circuit factor value, 0.6. This one is 0.8. So we assume CF1 0.2. Evidence 2 here has a minus 0.6. So we try to find the certain factor of C is Z. And then we can find that based on this. We already find, we need to find the circuit factor of this rule. We said the CF1, the poor rule is CF1. And this part applied is CF2. And CF1 is the CFE multiplied CF. CF of this V. And this one is CFE. E1, E2. Multiplex CF. This part. CFZ. G1, G2, we use 1 and 2 will be better. So we can find this one is 0.6 multiplies 0.6. And this part is the 0.6 because CF2 is 0.6. Multiplex, which one? 4.8. So we can find these two values. One is from CF1, one is from CF2. So this is positive. and this is negative. Based on the positive and negative, we can find this formula. Because one is positive, one is negative, is this part. If both of them are positive, is this part. So if we apply use their formula, we can find the result is 1 minus minima CF1 is this one. And then this part, CF1 minus CF1. So that means the value is 0.18 minus 0.84. So the result of this formula we can find that the result is negative. That means this, the rule of the circuit factor 2 is more heavy or more strong than CF1. So the result is more strong CF2, because finally we find that the value is 4.38. And this one is 0.88. So you can find that the result still less than 1. This is the importance of the circuit factor of the calculation. Okay. So, any question about the circuit factor operation? So now if I change the value, here is 0.2 and here is from minus 0.6 change it to 0.6, what the value of the circuit factor C is Z. So can you try to recall this value you can compute quickly or try to trace it? Both of the positive, so the result will be positive. If both are minus negative, the result will be negative. One is positive, one is negative, the result may be different. Okay. You now try to calculate if we get the result is 0.6, what the circuit factor result. then the result will be negative, will be positive. And then we need to care for this formula. In this formula, we can find if we extend it. If we extend it, that is CF1A, CF2. If we extend this formula, we can find that CF1 added CF2 minus CF1 multiplied CF2. This formula depends this. Because the value of the CF1 and CF2 is less than 1. So this two term multiplies the value is became smaller. So that means this two value added together, but minus both of them. But this is the same idea, CF1 and CF2 add CF1 multiply CF2. But CF1 CF2 is minus multiplied result will be plus. That means minus at the minus and then at the plus. But this two term multiplied result will less than both of them. This is based on the 30 factor. 30 factor.